All right, this next section somewhat combines what we just did in the previous section so that you can see it all put together. So normal distributions, again, what we're doing is we're taking this mean of 500 and standard deviation of 100, and we're going to convert it into the standard normal. So we're going to convert it here where it has a mean of 0 and a standard deviation of 1. So basically, we're going to transform these two together, transpose them one on top of the other. We do that by changing these. We need to go from real data, which is your x values, to z scores. So those z scores then look like plus or minus 3.49 standard deviation. So we're going to change them so that the z scores look like negative 3 to 3. So, first example, a national study found that college students worked an average of 22 hours per week. The standard deviation is 9 hours. So the average is 23, standard deviation is 9. Mean is 22, standard deviation is 9. A college student with a job is selected at random. Find the probability that that student works for less than 4 hours. So in this case, X is going to be less than 4 hours. Since it's less than, remember, less than is direct from the chart or from the calculator, because less is the way we want to go. So if I were to just quickly draw a sketch, and again, sketch is not necessary, but for some people they like to see it. So the mean here is going to be 22. Standard deviation, so if I add one standard deviation, I'm going to go 9 to the right, which would give me 31. If I went left one standard deviation, then I would have 22 minus 9, which is equal to 13. So again, this is plus 1 standard deviation. This is minus 1 standard deviation. If I go 2, then my next standard deviation, adding 9 more, would be at 40. And back it up, would be at 4. When I subtract. So these two here are plus or minus 2 standard deviations from the norm, from the average. What we want, coincidentally, is less than 4 hours. So technically, we want this slice of the pie. This one's going to make a little more sense once you see it, hopefully, because of how it all works out. So first thing I'm going to do is use my z formula and change the x value to a z. Change the x value to a z. So z is equal to, the x value I'm interested in is 4 minus my mean, which is 22, divided by the standard deviation, which is 9. It's negative 18 over 9, which is equal to negative 2. And the reason I thought this would make sense here is because, again, this is minus 2 standard deviations from the mean. Minus 2. So, basically what I did is I took this, I gave it an average of 0, I went 2 standard deviations from the norm, and I'm looking again at this piece to the right. So, same piece in red. The chart or the layout is different. So if I want to look at the table, then I would go to where z is equal to negative 2. So if we want to look at the chart, I want to look at where z is negative 2. So negative 2.0 0.9. So negative 2.0, sorry, it is backwards. Negative 2.0, it's not that value, but it's this value right here, which is 0.0228. So using the chart, we have 0.228, where z is equal to negative 2. Because again, we want the area under the curve. Remember, this is area. If I'm going to use my calculator, I can do the normal. Remember, C, C, F. Do the negative 10,000, comma, negative 2, comma, 0, comma, 1. And again, this first number might be that negative 1, B99, depending on how your calculator is set up. So if I go to my calculator, second distribution gives me my number 2 for the PDF. There's the negative 1, E99. Hit enter, then I'm going to type in negative 2. It's still 0 and 1. So I can go down to paste and enter. And my answer again, using the calculator, is 0.02275. 0.02275, which if we round would become approximately 0.022. Which is what this is up to this point when I start. So either way, either the chart or the calculator, both will work. It's up to you. So what does this mean? Okay, so how do we interpret it? So the probability of selecting a student who works less than 4 hours is equal to 0.0228 or 2.28% of working students. Remember, you have to pick a student who's working. Working students only work less than 4 hours per week. So again, if it's asking you for the probability, this would be your answer. If it's asking you for an interpretation, this would be your answer. So you have to read carefully as to what it's asking you to do. Okay, second example says, survey indicates that for each trip to a supermarket, a shopper spends an average of 43 minutes with a standard deviation of 12. So 43 minutes, standard deviation of 12. Mean equals 43, standard deviation equals 12. The lengths of the time in the store are normally distributed, which is good because they need to be so we can use the information we have available. The variable x is what we're using. So it's asking us to find two different times, but it's asking us to find the data and then interpret it. So A says find the probability that the shopper will be in the store for the store between 22 and 55 minutes. Okay. Remember, the between statement is the one we're going to look at the highest. And we're going to subtract the lowest. Anytime you see between, that's what we're going to look at. So we have two values here. We have x equals 52, and we have x equals 22. So highest is purple, the lowest is going to be in red. So for the highest, we're going to type in our calculator, normal CDF, the negative 10,000, again, or however you type in that number. We have to have Z-scores first. Sorry. So, which is good. You should catch yourself if you make the same mistake that I just did. So first thing we have to do is convert this to a Z. So Z equals the X value that we're looking for, 52 minus 43 divided by 12. Again, the X formula is Z equals X minus mu divided by standard deviation. So my Z score in this case is equal to 0.75. So now on my calculator, I'll do normal CDF negative 10,000, 0.75, 0, 1. And for X equal to 22, I have Z equals 22 minus 50, oops, minus 43. Divided by 12, which on your calculator gives us a negative 1.75. So I'm going to do normal CDF, normal CDF, negative 10,000, negative 1.75, 0, 1. And on my calculator, I'll do this one, but I'm not going to do them all. Hit second enter. I'm going to change that negative 2 to 0.75. Make sure you're changing everything you need to change if you're going to use that back button. And I get 0.77. 337, which will round. So this purple one is equal to 0.7734. The red value, if I use my calculator, again, turns out to be 0.0401. To get the between, I need to subtract these two. So I'm going to subtract, and I would have 0.7734 minus 0.0401, 3337, 0.7333. So if I were to interpret this, which says, this was the A part. The B part says, when 200 shoppers enter the store, how many shoppers would you expect to be in there for between 22 and 52 minutes? How many would you expect? Well, if we had 200 shoppers at the rate of basically 73% of them, if I multiply these two together, I end up with 146.66, because we're talking shoppers, that would be about 147 shoppers out of 200 should shop, would be in the store between 22 and 52 minutes. That would be your B part. Now, see, if you had 500 shoppers, then the rate would stay the same. It would still be about 73%, but the number of people in the store would change. All right, next one. more than 37 minutes. More than 37 minutes. So that would mean that x is going to be greater than 37. Because it's greater than 37, it's to the right of the graph, which means we're going to have to do some subtraction. We're going to have to subtract 1. So, first we're going to do a z-score. So, z equals the x, 37, minus the average in the store, which was 43, divided by 12. 37 minus 40, or, yeah, minus 43. Now, this is going to be negative, which is fine. Ends up being negative 0.5. So if I do the normal, CDF, negative 10,000, negative 0.5, 0, 1, I end up with a value of 0.3085. And again, this would be left. We want right. So it's going to be 1 minus 0.3085, which is 0.6915. So that'll be my value. The B part, it's again, if 200 shoppers came in, this is A. If 200 shoppers came in, how many of that 200 would you expect to be in for more than 37, so 200 times 0.6915 would equal approximately 138 shoppers. So 138 would be in the store greater than or more than 37 minutes. You could also say, what is the probability of selecting a person? So the probability of randomly selecting a person who spends 37 minutes or more, so greater than 37 minutes. I guess I should put the greater than symbol here. Who spends greater than 37 minutes is equal to 0.6915. Probability would be that. So depending on how the question is asked. This is the probability of randomly selecting. Remember, the probability of an event has to be between 0 and 1. So make sure that if it's asking for probability, your answer really is a decimal between 0 and 1. Then I left this one for you guys to try. Talks about triglyceride levels. We want a triglyceride level less than 100. If you use everything correctly, that should be your correct answer. And that wraps up this section.